So, we want to do some translations of pick lists. In many cases, you have a pick list like this one, the stage, in your document, or any other pick list that you can have, and you actually want to translate it in the language of your customer. In our case, our customer is German, so we might want to use the German translation of this pick list. Okay, let's take a look. First of all, we have to make sure that our pick list stage is translated. So let's take a look at a translation workbench inside the setup menu. We take the language German, the pick list value on the opportunity, and on stage we see that not all but some of them are translated. If there is an issue with the translation or anybody would feel offended by the bad translation, I blame Google Translate. I'm not a German speaking person, sorry for that. So we have a German translation here, and that's what I want to use inside my document. Okay, now let's tell the system to get the translation. We go to data sources, new data source. It's a pick list translation. Ah, what did you think? Let's call it data source demo pick list translation. Okay, the translation object is in this case opportunity. Can be any object, of course, also custom objects. If it's translated inside the workbench, it will be it can be used as a translation object. And the pick list in this case is stage. So that's the field name, the API field name here of my pick list. Let's take a look if I'm 100% sure that my API name is called stage, or is it stage name? Yeah, see, luckily I saw that it's stage name. So let's take the stage name here and we save it. So we know that the API name is stage name, that's the fields that I want to translate on the opportunity. So now let's go back to our document and let's add the translation as a config type. It's always config types, of course, that we are adding. So back to our document. First of all, add the translation pick list. Okay, there is no field, but you have to add a dummy field. That's no issue here. So just add a dummy field, add it to the document. Let's take a look in our document. What's actually here? So we have our translation, translate me. So here we want to put the translated stage. Add config type, translate me. It's going to be of type single, which is fine. The data source is going to be our single data source, and the field is going to be the the stage is not selected yet, so no problem. We just go back to our single data source here. We add the stage as a field. Add field, review, save query. Okay. Cool. So the field was added. We go back here to our single data source. We just refresh the configuration so it knows that this field is also now part of the list here. Okay, and let's do this again. We add our single. The single data source field is stage name. So the merge field is translate me. And yes, I want to translate this. And which data source I want to use as a translation? I want to use a translation pick list, of course. So the system is now going to be smart enough to know that the text that's inside this field, stage name, I want to use the translated text from the translation pick list. Okay, that's all there is to it. Save it, save to server. And now let's take a look. Go back to our car demo. If I now click the PDF button, it will take all of the information, send it out to PDF Butler, and the document is already there. So the previewer showed it, and if everything went okay, it indeed shows the translated pick list value. Okay, not 100% convinced. Let's take another person here. Let's take Inge Janssens, who's Dutch speaking. So if I save this, You will see that she's Dutch. And let's take a look at the Dutch translation for that. I regenerate my document, takes all of the information. Oh, damn, that was fast. Document is already created. The preview is there, and see, now it's in Dutch. So we have our pick list translation coming out of the translation workbench, which is pretty cool. Thank you for watching.